Curious din pala kami to ask you, how do you decide which artist to bring here in the country?
Well, the decision of which artist to bring in the country, it always lies on what I currently listen to. For me, ever since when I started it, it was very personal for me. And it worked because that's how I get to communicate with the fans. That's how I understand what they want. And that's how I service them back. With me, I focus on whatever I'm listening to, whatever I like. And then if it's their time to tour, that's when I ask for it. And then I plan for it.
And is it a requirement that you watch their live performances before you can decide who to bring in?
Well, so most of the management, they would ask me to go to Korea, or sometimes if they have an earlier stop before the Philippines, I have to go there and watch it because they have to show me what's going to happen. Para I could start planning for it in Manila. So at least when I see a show, I know immediately what we don't have in Manila. So we start looking elsewhere na. Especially when it's a big show, it's a requirement that we have to go and watch it.
Miss Happy, sobrang naka-curious talaga ako. So pag dinadala mo dito yung mga idols na favorite natin, pina-plan out mo ba how you can give them like a touch of our country? Like sa food ba, do you sort of insert some Filipino food sa mga ano nila, sa mga dishes nila? Or do you somewhat plan how you can show them a bit of the Philippines pag pupunta sila dito?
Yes, definitely. Especially when the artist is first time. Because like I remember the very first time the BTS came, they were not so big yet that time. So I brought them to Malate. So okay lang
sila
sa Malate.
Dinala mo sila sa Malate?
Yeah, they were just, yeah, I know, right? Lakad-lakad lang sila sa Malate. So I like them to feel how it is in the Philippines. So nagigets nila how our lifestyle is. During the shows naman in the backstage, usually with the help of the fan club of the artist, because we always have local fan clubs of the artist, and then there's a lot of them usually. They would always support it with that. They always would give them, like, you know, those little jeepneys?
Yeah, yung mga... Like,
they would always, yes, they would always give you mga dried mangoes. They have some fans who are coming from Davao, from Bacolod. They bring in
gifts,
the specialty of their provinces. Yes, and then me naman, it's my job. I try and make sure that they really get it and then they really get to try it, which most of the time they do naman. Kasi like now, meron na silang favorite brand ng dried mango, yung ganyan. Diba some of them have come back 2-3 times na. They know na what to expect, what food they like.
Nakakatuwa naman. So, including yung mga fan clubs, you really help these different fan groups also get in touch with their idols. Is there like a, ano lang, may mga limitations something for them? Or is there, how do you do it?
Every time an artist is gonna come to Manila, the fan club would reach out to me na so we can start talking about what they wanna do. And then once they plan what they wanna do, they're gonna come up with a proposal. And then I would fix it up in a way wherein it's easier for the Koreans to understand. And then I would send it to Korea for approval. And then I'll be the one basically parang ahente nila to make it happen. So everything that you see, even during a show, sometimes all the fans put up a banner, put up a sign, tapos lahat yan, same color, ganyan. It's all in collaboration with the artist management and the fan club and the local fan club. My job there really is just to give them the parang the opportunity to connect and then at the same time to make it happen. But all of those ideas, it's really the initiative of the local fan clubs.
Nakakatuwa.
So, yeah.
Yung effort ng fans. Iba talaga pag fans ng mga idols natin eh. Parang sobrang grabe yung collaborative work nila. Hindi lang yung parang punta lang sa mall shots, may dala na agad. And I think yung experience pa din siguro Happy as an artist also helped out with that.
Oh yes, definitely. It made me more sensitive to what they are feeling. With me, having that opportunity to do it before makes me more sensitive to how the artists are feeling. So priority ko yan, like talaga they have to be really, like a lot of people are saying I'm too strict in the backstage, but for me kasi if my artist is not feeling well pag lumabas yan sa stage, hindi siya happy, irritado na yan eh. So I always make sure that they're happy backstage before they go up the stage, and they're very whatever they like, alam mo yung lahat bibigay ko yan, and then to the point na super happy siya na pag lumabas yan ng stage, lahat gusto niya ibigay sa fans. And by the before, even before they go down, lahat ng food, lahat ng ano nila ready na rin. Basta lagi one step ahead ako. I'm very sensitive with that because I feel like they do their job right. I do my job right. Everybody happy. Parang ganyan.
Tsaka pag when you treat them right, lagi na naiisip na, ang babait ng mga Pilipino, sobrang...
Yes, exactly. Nila. So parang at least pala, kaya tuloy parang, diba, lagi nila hindi makalimutan Philippines. E paano may lechon lagi sa likod nila? Yung mga ganyan. So parang, what's that? Diba?